Today, I'm going to be doing a voice coach reacts to Adam Lambert's Believe from the 41st Kennedy Center Honors. Keep watching. Hi everybody, I'm Christi Bovee from the Voice Love Company. Please like and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the little bell so you don't miss any of the upcoming videos or when I go live. I have a free 5 days to a more powerful voice e-course. It comes to your inbox one video per day, and you can get all the details down below. Let's get started. There's something really special that Adam Lambert does as a vocalist that I think if you know this technique, it can help you too. So let's watch.
Keep pushing me aside and I can't break through. There's no talking to you. It's so sad that you're leaving. It takes time to believe it. After all that's said and done, you're gonna be the lonely one. Oh, do you believe?
This arrangement slays me.
I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough now. Do you believe in life after love? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough now.
Good, so I'm going to stop it right there. And I don't know if you noticed it, but I want you to watch it for the rest of the video because he does it consistently. He pushes his tongue forward. He does not have any tongue tension, and you're going to see that in this video. And the reason that I'm pointing it out is because tongue tension closes off the sound in the back of the throat. And what he even did there, I can feel something inside me say, he's pushing his tongue forward. So when he's pushing his tongue forward like that, it's going to allow the sound to really flow out. He has an incredible amount of control over his instrument and clarity in his sound because he is really keeping his tongue down and forward. Okay, let's keep watching.
What am I supposed to do? Sit around and wait for you. Well, I can't do that.
There we go. So you see what he did right there. And I can't do that. He's keeping that tongue forward and flat. And his tongue is really relaxed too. You can just see it's just kind of flat and sassy in there. Okay, here we go. He's pulling out his in-ear monitor on one side, I notice. Here we go.
There's no turning back.
Back.
It takes time.
You see it? It takes time to move on. Everything is very forward. Oh, okay.
To feel strong. Cause I got time to think it through. And baby, I'm too good for you. Do you believe?
Reba McEntire is wishing she could sing like him right now. And as well as everybody in the room, they're all just enthralled. I wish they had more camera shots on him though. I don't want to see everybody in the audience.
I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough. Do you believe in life after love? I can feel something inside.
So you see how he pulls back? I really don't think it's strong enough, no. So he's pulling back his mic, allowing the microphone to help with that dynamic shift, which is a beautiful technique to use as well.
And I know that I'll get through this. Cause I know that I am strong.
Okay, that's one place that I wish he had done something a little different. This is a very theatrical performance, but I wish he'd not done the little breath in both times. And I know that I'll get through this. And I know that I'll be strong. I wish he'd just done something a little different. They were just almost identical. So nitpicking, but yeah.
I don't need you anymore. I don't need you anymore. I don't need you anymore.
His jaw is so relaxed there. I don't need you anymore. I don't need you anymore. Ah, just relaxed jaw, relaxed tongue. Here we go.
I don't need you anymore. Do you believe in life after love? I can feel something inside me say,
okay, he's literally sticking his tongue out. Yeah, there's nothing gonna get in your way when you do that. Try it next time. Stick your tongue out. A lot of my students, they feel weird doing this because they think it looks stupid. Well, it does maybe look a little stupid. You know what? It works. It works. When you show up and you're confident and you've got the goods vocally, who cares if you're sticking your tongue out? Adam Lambert is a perfect example of that. And Cher right now is thinking, oh my goodness, get this arranger on the line because I want him to arrange all of my songs now for my next Best Of album because this was amazing. Okay, here we go. So, do you believe in life after love? And he did another one of those little gasp breaths for effect. Ooh, everything's nice and relaxed. Ooh, and my tongue is very forward. That's the key and that's the trick. It's what he's doing right, for sure. Oh my goodness. So let's talk a little bit about how you can get better tongue relaxation. So here's my plastic larynx. What? You don't have a plastic larynx? What? Now this is this part of your body right here. This is the hyoid bone. The tongue, the back of the tongue sits right here. This is the epiglottis that keeps food and water out of the windpipe. And the back of the tongue is going to sit here. Your tongue is rather large. We only see a small part of it. It goes all the way back and sits back here, back into the throat. So when you can imagine, if you have tongue tension, you're going to have laryngeal tension because this is all connected. What we're wanting to do is loosen up your tongue as much as possible. So let's talk about some ways to do that. Put a thumb up underneath your chin right here, and we're gonna just massage a little bit. You can actually use both thumbs just to massage. If you feel a lot of pain and pressure up and underneath here, it's probably because you have tension in your tongue. Move your tongue around a little bit. You're going to be able to feel that muscle moving. We're going to just massage a little bit right here, and that'll help loosen it up. Now, besides just the regular tongue stretches that you can do, which is like back of the throat, as far as down as you can, try to touch the tip of your nose with your tongue, like that, which I can't do. You can go side to side, around, right? Just trying to kind of get it to loosen up. Then you can also use an NG sound, like in the word sing, we're gonna make the ng sound, and just do a ng, ng. It puts the resonance up back in the soft palate. It brings everything just to a place where it gets the tongue up and out of that clenchy spot in the back of the throat. Another thing that you can do is make a guh sound with your tongue jutting forward. A guh, guh, guh. Now this not only works your tongue and helps it kind of relax and move forward, it also helps your larynx lower down as well. So we do a guh, guh, guh. Another thing to try is sing your piece with your tongue sticking out. So, past your self-consciousness, amazing things can happen, because then you're not only just more relaxed and able to make the sound, but you're also able to just try different things that will help you loosen up that tongue tension. I hope this video was helpful for you. Like if you liked it, subscribe. If you have any suggestions of who I should react to next, leave a comment down below. If you know somebody who's struggling with tongue tension or somebody who just loves Adam Lambert and thinks he's amazing like I do, please be sure to share this video with them. In the poll this week, I have a list of vocalists that I'm kicking around the idea of doing Voice Coach Reacts videos to. Leave your vote up above on where I should start first. You can always ask me questions about your voice in the comments down below. Find me on my blog at voicelove.co or on Facebook, Instagram, or Pinterest as The Voice Love Company. I sure thank you for joining me today. Isn't Adam Lambert an incredible vocalist? And now you see one of those little tricks that he uses to keep his tongue, his jaw, his larynx nice and relaxed so he can get that fabulous sound. I hope you learned something today that you can take forward in your singing and that you will remember you are loved. Bye-bye.